Hey guys, and welcome back to a new video. Today I'm inside new Mazda 2 and I want to talk about multimedia system. The multimedia system from Mazda, they haven't updated for a long time and I think it's time for an update. But in this video I will still present you the old version because I didn't have this on my channel, so I still want to show you that if some of you want to buy a Mazda car in 2021. It should know how the multimedia system look like. Let's go forward. First of all, the cockpit, it's still the classic cockpit. I wish they will also update this one here in the future. Let's go to the multimedia system. The great part of it is the fact that you can use the controllers here while you're driving. It's much more easier to use those buttons. Home, navigation, media, back, and all that stuff. It's much more easy to use it like that while you're driving. But sometimes these days it's also awesome to have a touch screen. The new update of it is the fact that you can use it as a touch screen. Before you can do that, but now you can also use it as a touch screen. But it's not so, I don't know how to tell you, it's not so easy to go through menu as it is on other cars, but still it's very responsive. I like the fact that it's very responsive also when you use it as a touchscreen, but the screen, it's a little bit too far away, so it's very, very inconvenient while you're driving to reach out there. So you will still be locked with this controller. So yeah, much better use the controller, guys. Now, what you can do in the multimedia system, this car doesn't have the navigation installed. It's a brand new car, but I have a video on my channel I already made, how can you connect your Android phone to the multimedia system. Check it out because it's totally deserved to see it if you want to buy a Mazda. There I show you how you can use the Google map from Android. It's much better than the map that comes with the car anyway. Then, first of all, you have the application that I told you before. You can connect Android Auto, Apple CarPlay. Here is the vehicle status monitoring. Here it tells you all kind of maintenance, when you have to make the maintenance, oil, tire rotation and stuff like that. Warning guidance here, if you have some warning, low fuel, for example, in this moment, the car doesn't have so much fuel. It's a brand new car, it's normal. Fuel economy monitoring, here it shows you some kind of tips about that, so that's also quite nice. And also you can see right here all kind of information about that. Reset the fuel consumption, then you have the next screen, application and settings right here. Let's go back to home. Then the next one, it's multimedia system. Here is the multimedia system, radio, Bluetooth and all that stuff. Then the next one is communication. Here you can use your phone. You can connect your phone and all other functions from the phone. Then you have the navigation, that it doesn't have it installed on this car here. And then you have the settings. Here are a lot of things that you can change and adjust. For example, here's the brightness. Then the next one is the display. You can choose how you like to have it, day, night. For example, right now it's on auto. Going back to display, you can choose wherever you want to have it, the contrast and all that stuff. Then you have the safety, smart city brake support, blind spot monitoring, lane keep assist, parking sensors. You can activate it and deactivate it. Here is the sound, balance and all other options for the sound. And the next one is the vehicle. Here on the vehicle, the raining sensors, wipers, door lock, turn lights, alarm and all other settings of the system. Device, Bluetooth, Android Auto, you already see it, and the system. Here on the system you can change the language, you can change the temperature, distance in Fahrenheit, miles, kilometer, wherever. And also you can reset it from the factory. It's a simple multimedia system. It's nothing fancy, nothing crazy, but it's very responsive. You can go very easy to every single menu, and you have those shortcut button here, physical, that help you a lot. If you connect it to Android Auto, it will be much, much easier. Also, I wish in the future to make it a little bit bigger. But other than that, the colors, the resolution, it's quite good. And yeah, it's not bad quality, I should say. The software, it's simple, it's easy to use. And if you use it, as I said, with Android Auto or iPhone phones, will be fun, will be really cool. Anyway, check out the other video with Android Auto if you want to see how it looks on the screen with map and all that. And yeah, I guess that was the video. If you have questions, just ask me down below. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to see the newest video. Also, I have the review with Mazda 2 on my channel. If you want to see the video, check it out. Thank you again for watching. Stay safe and I guess I see you soon in the next one. Bye guys.